Hi students, let's continue with our network security attacks, that are the active attacks. We are discussing about the active attacks. So in that I explained the different types of network layer attacks. Now let's see the transport layer attacks, application layer attacks, and some other attacks that are present in the that we call active attacks. The transport layer attack. In the transport layer attack, the attack that occurs is a session hijacking. So the transport layer is mainly used to establish the sessions. Okay, so the session is and it is used to transfer the data from one source to the destination. Here the session hijacking, an adversary takes control over the session between two nodes. Since most authentication process are carried out only at the start session, so once a session between two nodes get established, the adversary node pretend as one of the end-to-end nodes of the session and hijacks the session. So here a two nodes a communication will be a session will be established in the transport layer. So here the adversary node is going to pretend and saying something as it's a wrong direction as one of the end nodes of the sessions and hijacking the sessions. And coming to the another active attack, that is the application layer attack, is repudiation. So what is this repudiation? It refers to denial or attempted denial by a node involved in a communication of having participated in all or part of the communications. So here the application layer attack refers to the denial or attempted denial by a node which are involved in a communication having participated in all or a part of the communications. And coming to the other attacks that are present in the that we call it as an active attacks. Multi-layer attacks could occur in any layer of the network protocol stack. So those are denial of service and impersonation, and the remaining one is the device tampering. So these are the three attacks that we call it as a multi-layer attacks, which could occur in any layer of the network protocol. So not only in the network layer, these type of attacks may be occurred in the MAC layer, network layer, transport layer, and even the application layer also. There is a chance of occurring in each and every layer. So the first is a denial of service. So this denial of a service may occur in any of the layer. An adversary node attempts to prevent authorized users from accessing the service. You call it as a denial of a service. Okay. An adversary attempts to prevent the authorized users from accessing the service. Not the unauthorized. Authorized users are not able to access the service. So in that cases, we got the denial of a service. So the different types of why we get the denial of a service attack, because of the jamming. Here the adversary initially keeps monitoring the wireless medium in order to determine the frequency at which receiver node is receiving the signals from sender. So here the frequent hopping spread spectrum FHSS and the direct sequence spread spectrum DSSS commonly used technologies to overcome the jamming attacks. And another denial of service is a synchronous flooding. Not only the jamming, the synchronous flooding is also a denial of service. An adversary node sends a large number of synchronous packets to victim nodes. So here these victim nodes builds a table which are used to hold the information regarding all pending connections. So since suppose the maximum possible size of the table is limited, the increasing number of half connections results in overflow in the table. Okay, so up to the capacity it can hold the data. Suppose if it increases the maximum possible size of a table, the increasing number of half connections results in overflow in the table. That you call it as a flooding, synchronous flooding. And another denial of a service is a distributed denial of service attacks. Here the several adversaries attacks a service at the same time, that you call it as a distributed denial of service attacks. And another type of attack that may occur in any of the layer is the impersonation. Here they disrupt the normal functionality of a network by injecting false routing information into the network. Here, the man in middle attack is also another type of impersonation attack. Means it's just deviating the network. And the last type, that is the attack that could occur in any of the layer in the network protocol stack, is the device tampering. Device tampering. Unlike nodes in a wide network, nodes in the ad hoc wireless networks are usually compact, soft, handheld in nature. So unlike the other nodes, why in the case of the wide network, the nodes in the ad hoc wireless network are also usually compact, soft and handheld in nature, and they could get damaged or stolen easily also. Okay, so these are all the different network security attacks: the jamming, wormhole, black hole, Byzantine information disclosure, resource consumption, routing attacks, session hijacking, repudiation, denial of a service, impersonation, manipulation of network traffic, and the device tampering. Thank you.